Simpson, and right now, as you can see, I am with a hood. Well, actually, he's a good hood, though. His name is Jelly Bean Johnson. Jelly Bean, welcome to the show.
Thanks.
As you can see, right now, we're in the studio of Flight Time Productions. This is where it actually happens. You guys do vocals here?
Vocals and drums and some overdubs, and do some overdubs and drum overdubs sometimes, and percussion. Mm-hmm. Get up in here. Yeah.
You play drums.
Uh-huh.
That's what you're known for, of course. I played for all the years with the time.
Yeah.
You were the drummer. But I understand you also play guitar.
Yeah, I try. You know, I like the guitar. It's an emotional instrument for me, you know, so.
What do you mean it's an emotional instrument?
Well, I'm into the guitar, but like the old blues guitar players, like Albert King and B.B. King and stuff, those are emotional guitar players.
Yeah.
You know, and I like that. You know, I always thought the guitar was an emotional instrument. Hendrix, mm-hmm. My all-time favorite is Hendrix.
Is that right?
I guess you had Jesse on one time, and he was saying that also about Hendrix.
Right.
Yeah.
Yeah, well, you're going to hear a lot of Hendrix and Jesse's playing.
Yeah.
There's no question. He's
That's
a big fan of his.
That's the man.
So was he the inspiration for you learning how to play guitar?
Yes.
Was it Jimi Hendrix?
It was. I guess I can say that now, yeah.
Yeah. Who was the inspiration for you learning how to play the drums?
When I was coming up, it was James Brown Records and Lenny White and David Garibaldi. Those guys. And there was also, I should mention this, a lot of other drummers have mentioned, it's a guy that played in a group called Cold Blood named Sandy McKee. It was around, 69 or 70. He was really, really something. Yeah.
Is there? Okay. Yeah. I'm not familiar with him.
Yeah. Are you familiar with the group Cold Blood?
No.
Oh, okay.
No.
Well, yeah, they weren't that big a band. They were a Bay Area band.
Yeah.
They were like, remember, like Tower Power?
Okay, right.
They were a band like that.
Yeah, well, I had to pull an album. Maybe you have it. I'd like to hear it.
I'd like to hear it. Incredible. He was an incredible drummer. Yeah, he was.
A couple of weeks ago, you guys reunited in Minneapolis for the Minnesota Black Musicians Award.
Yeah.
And it was an historical night, really, because, you know, we've seen so many acts break up, and it's a shame, you know, but it happens. And you guys broke up in 83, but everyone got back together for that one night. I mean, Morris Day up front, Jesse Johnson on guitar, Jimmy and Terry, yourself.
Yeah.
What was that experience like?
No, Donnie, I can't describe it. I mean, it's like a dream come true. It was like a dream come true. I remember Terry used to tell me, and I must say this, he used to tell me about, or like right after they had left and stuff, we're going to get back together. And I didn't believe him, you know. I really didn't honestly believe it would happen because of the way it happened and stuff. And so, you know, just for that night to happen was, oh, man. I was telling Jimmy that night, I couldn't believe, just the anticipation was killing me, you know? Mm-hmm. But it was great. It was great fun.
So it felt good on stage again?
It felt good. Well, I got a little rust, but...
All the guys mentioned that to me, that there was a little rust. But as a fan, and as just someone sitting there in the audience watching the show, I mean, I couldn't believe that you guys only got together for 3 or 4 days of rehearsal played that well together.
I mean, I had to, you know, I got my calluses back in those 3 or 4 days. I mean, I used to have calluses, you know, from playing all the time and stuff. And it's just getting them back and getting the whole body to do that again was an experience, you know. But it felt good.
Is this something we're going to see more of? Do you think you guys will go out and do a tour?
Well, I hope so. You know, it's not up to me.
Yeah.
You know, whatever they want to do, they know I've always, you know. I'm a team player.
Right.
You know? That's what I'll be. I'm always going to be.
You have other interests yourself.
Yeah.
Because you, we know you produced the Nona Hendrix, part of the Nona Hendrix Project.
Mm-hmm.
Is that your main interest now, your main focus, is to start your own production career?
Yeah, I want to try to, my whole thing, I want to keep up, you know, in the time you got so many talented guys that produce and do everything, and I'm just trying to keep up, you got Grammy winning producers, and you got, you know, ace guitar players, you got Morris as a character in himself, and Jerome, you know, I have to keep up, so I got to do something, Donnie.
I hadn't thought of it like that, but that's a lot of pressure, isn't it?
Yeah. Money.
I mean, really, that's kind of like Saturday Night Live. You know, when you look at, seriously, when you look at the talent came out of that show, you talk about a Chevy Chase and a Gilda Ratner and an Eddie Murphy.
Yeah.
You know,
it's
incredible, the talent that has come out of the time. And you feel a lot of pressure to keep up.
Well, it's not so much pressure, it's just I want to keep up. I want to put it on myself to say that, hey, I want to keep up with these guys. Yeah. These guys are great, and I just want to keep up. They're my friend. They're my brothers, and I think they're great, so I want to, you know, participate. Yeah. Hang.
Well, that's one thing I admire about you guys, too, is the fact that even during the years that you haven't been together, you work together. I mean, you're still brothers, you know, you still hang out here at the studio all the time. Yeah. You come in and you produce Nona and you do your thing here as well. So, anyway, continued success to you.
Thank you.
And
we
hope to see you up there smiling with a big award saying, this is my Grammy, Producer of the Year one day.
Well,
Jelly
see.
Bean Johnson.
Thank you, Doc.
All right, good luck to you.
Yeah.
We're
going to
take a look at cut we mentioned that he did produce. It's from Nona Hendrix, and it's called Why Should I Cry? This is my man, Jelly Bean, on Video Soul.